to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding.
Hallelujah. storm. Yes. And my question is, don't give up in the storm.
Don't give up.
Don't give up in the storm. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can tell you from my own experience that the problem of life can sometimes come upon us that before we can get one thing straightened out, it bombards with another.
Right.
And no one can better testify that than Job. Job, as you may recall, faced a serious problem that came upon him. You know, Job had a lot of trouble. He had a lot of problems come upon him. But Job never gave up.
Amen.
His wife told him to curse your God and die. Job said, what were you talking about? Curse my God and die? I know I'm in a storm, but God's going to bring me out of the storm. Brawls came on him. All the things friends talked about him. Told him, Job, you must have did something wrong. His brother said to him, you know, I always have to do anything wrong. So Job didn't do anything wrong, but he was tested by the devil.
That's right.
You're going to be tested, y'all. Hallelujah. You say you're praying to know the Lord, you're going to be tested.
Yes.
Things are going to come, hallelujah. But what you want to do? God said, I'll be with you in the storm.
Uh-huh.
I'll be with you when you come out of the storm.
Yes.
Amen. So if God is with you, he tell you, don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
Yes. I'm here right here with you.
Right.
And look here. We got to let God take control of that storm.
Yes, yes.
We can't just jump out of the storm trying to handle it ourselves. Amen.
Right.
We got to let God take care of that storm. Look, we got to fast and pray and keep on as things begin to happen in our life. Hallelujah. We got to let God take care of it.
Yes.
And that's what he said he would do.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes life is just like an old saying. When it rains, it pours.
Yes.
And for the reason Job said in Job 14:11, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. Amen. A few days in his life, but it will be trouble all every day of our life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Because
the enemy is going to keep on attacking us. Hallelujah. How many come give God some praise today? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And as it was with Job, it was here in the text. We find Paul in major trouble. And just because we are the child of God doesn't mean that we're not going to have trouble.
Uh-huh.
Look here. Trouble is going to come.
Yes.
We think just because we get saved, hallelujah, that everything is peace and cream now.
Uh-huh.
Amen? It's not. Amen. When you get saved, trouble is going to come. Trouble is already coming, as I say, but you just don't identify with it.
Right.
Where it's coming from. You don't know where it's from. You know it's just happening to you.
Yeah.
But when you accept what's going around, you, amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. You begin to know that the enemy's attacking you. Amen. Hallelujah. But how you going to defend yourself? Not by your own,
right,
but by the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 The question of the this morning is not when the storm comes, but how should we respond when the storm comes? How are you going to respond when the storm comes? Amen. Are you going to run and hide? Amen. Are you going to try to speak to the devil on your own?
Wow.
You know, when Jesus went up on the mountain, he didn't speak not one word of his own.
Oh,
when the enemy attacked him, he spoke the word.
Yeah.
He said, cut these stones into braids of man should not live by bread alone, but every word you see out of the mouth of God.
Oh,
right. Amen. Man should not live by bread alone. Hallelujah. But by every word.
Amen.
Word. I'm going to say it again. They do it immediately.
Yes.
Immediately they get to the job.
Yes.
Amen. But we got to wonder and think, and who said it? Did you think God said that? Did you say that? You think he meant this?
Wow.
He meant what he said.
Yes.
And we need to get right, look here, we need to move on that thing right then.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because look, sometimes God he drops in and puts something on you, and if you don't take it right then, it moves on away.
Come on.
Amen. You got Hallelujah. Where was I? Amen. And just in case there's someone looking at me today, who finds himself in the midst of a storm, I submit to you this morning, don't give up in the storm.
Amen.
Don't give up. There are some lessons that we can learn from this episode in the life of the Apostle Paul that we can serve as a tool that will help us from encountering any mini storm. First thing we can learn is they didn't listen. Mm-hmm. Paul told them not to take this yarn.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Sometimes we don't listen to the pastor when he preaches.
Yes.
Let me ask you a question. If you went to an English class, amen, and you was going to give you a test, you went there and you didn't listen to nothing. The teacher said, I told my son this years ago, and when he failed the test, he's in that topic problem. And I told him, you can't fill the test. The teacher was taught what you're supposed to remember. You wouldn't listen, take notes.
Wow.
Look, this set right here is just like a classroom setting. You come here every Sunday, all Thursday night, to stand for prayer. If you're not learning anything, when the devil gives you the test, you ain't gonna pass it.
Wow.
And then believe me, a test is coming. Amen. So if you come here on Sunday and you sit in this classroom here and the word is being spoken, to say. They don't know what he's talking about. Amen. Oh, I know more than you know. Amen. Maybe you do, but you know more than God knows. Amen. Because God speaks to the man of God. Amen. He speaks to you too. Amen. But you got to always say this right here. And the purpose is, I always say this right here, is that God, the king, is not going to let the devil speak first.
All right.
When we start rattling, when God speaks to us, he's going to speak first. Then the enemy's going to speak.
That's right.
Just like God spoke to Adam first. Then the enemy said, did God say that? Did he say that? God tell you something good to do, and the enemy say, did God say that? No, he meant you to do it. When we start worrying about that seventh thing that comes into our mind,
yeah,
we make our mistake.
Yeah.
How do I know? Because I did it before myself. Amen?
Oh,
hallelujah.
Amen.
There are those who freak in the pew Sunday after Sunday who are not listening to a thing that is being preached.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? We hear it. But it go one ear and out the other. How I know that? Because we're still in the same since we were in when we first came to church. Nothing changed.
Wow.
If nothing is changing, then you are not using the word of God.
That's right.
So nothing's going to change just by not speaking the word.
That's right.
It ain't going to change because you want it to change.
Uh-huh.
It ain't going to change because you think it should change.
Come on.
Amen. It's going to change because you got to do something.
Yes.
You're going to get paid if you don't want to work.
Come on.
Amen. Unless you got a little leave or something.
Yeah.
But look here. Praise the Lord. But look here. Nothing's going to change in your situation if you don't make an effort.
Right.
Amen. Hallelujah. The many people make true in the old days. I know Brother Hall was like this right here. They don't have to say that your body is here with me, but your mind is on the other side of town.
Right.
In the old days, you sang that song. Your body is here with me. Your body is here with me. But your mind is on the other side of town. Amen?
Wow.
You're here in church, but you worry about what's going on outside of church.
Wow.
Worry about the Super Bowl coming at 6:30 today, y'all. But look at here. Come on back in the church. Come on back here with me now.
Yes.
We know where it's coming off, so you ain't got to worry about that. But we got to get our mind adjusted. Because see, in church, so many things are going on. Amen? So many things attract your attention. But I tell you, somebody sat inside your ear and taught you to move to another seat.
Yeah.
Amen. Because when the word is going forth, amen, and you want to be listening to what's happening, what's going on. Because if you've been praying and asking God for deliverance from something, asking God for the answer to your prayer, the word that your answer might be in the word that day.
Amen.
If you're not listening, you miss it.
Right.
Amen. Because God, how are you going to speak properly through someone the prayer that you're asking for?
That's right.
Amen. It's going to come from somebody. Because we need financially, God's not going to come back and put money in your hand. He's going to use somebody that's going to obey him, that's going to give the money to you that you need.
That's right.
God don't have any dollar bills up in heaven.
Right.
Amen.
That's right.
All the money is down here.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Amen?
Yes.
Look, your healing is down here.
Down.
Your deliverance is down here.
Down.
Your prosperity is down here.
Down.
Your kids get saved is down here.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Whatever you need is down here.
Down.
You can have to work down here to get it. You don't need when you get to hell. Hallelujah. You need it right here. Hallelujah. I come today that Jesus said that you can be healed. Hallelujah. If you use his word. You know what I say? Some people are at church, but they're not really in church. Amen. They here, they come here because they're going to do on Sunday. Amen. But you should come here looking for something. And I know in this church, everybody needs something.
Amen.
Some needs are greater than others. But everybody needs something from God. Because whatever we need, we can't get it on our own. We might think that we can get it on our own. But we can't. God is the giver of life and everything that we need. He said he owns 1,000 cows, 1,000 deer. And everything belongs to him. Amen. Hallelujah. That David mentioned the message so often. that the one is given, but because we're not listening, we find ourselves in a stormy situation. Hallelujah. I can go beyond the preacher and say that there are some people here right now who wish they had listened to their mother and father, their grandmother and granddad. Grandma knows what she's talking about. She's different that stuff and all that stuff. She don't know what's happening. She's old now. You know what I'm saying? But I tell you one thing, all the things that they told me came back to haunt me. All the things that I didn't listen to what they said came back to haunt me. Amen? Because when I stepped out, I said, man, mama told me not to do this. But I didn't listen. But they would tell us for our good. Amen? And that's the same thing that Jesus is trying to do. He's trying to be the granddad, the grandmama, the mom, the dad, whatever you need in this life. Hallelujah. And when we don't listen, there's some consequences.
That's right.
Amen? If we don't listen, there's some consequences.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Another thing I want to say is that they departed too soon. Paul told them not to go, but they departed too soon. Amen?
Yeah.
Sometimes we can depart too soon, y'all. Hallelujah. But I can't really criticize the captain that too much. If I would be told honest that there have been times in my life, me, when I had departed too soon. Now what comes to last out too soon, maybe? Well, when we jump into something without God's endorsement. Sometimes God tells us to do something that, listen, like you said, brother said, y'all miss a lot of things on Thursday night, I'm telling you.
Amen.
I was talking to the pastor and said, you know, preacher over the church, he fixes it up and everything, but he tells us, somebody had to pay for that.
Right.
Amen. God tells us to do something, we jump out and just run. And sometimes we don't even consider God, we just go out and do it.
Yeah.
Look, if you're a Christian, you should put God in everything that you do. You should see God in everything you do.
That's right.
Whether you buy a car, a house, because the people out there to beat you.
Uh-huh.
If you don't have someone to have someone that will experience,
uh-huh,
you're going to get beat.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. What did it say? Without God's direction, sometimes God needs to direct us in the way that we should go.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You know, some of us, we can't stand direction. We don't want nobody to tell us what to do. You know? We got that pride about it. You can't tell me what to do. Shit. Anyway, I can't tell you what to do. But let me tell you something. When people say something to you like that, it's because they care about you. So if I didn't care about it, I'm just going to break your neck. Amen? They call that agape love. If someone comes to tell you, see you doing something wrong, and they come to say something to you about it, don't take it in a negative way. Take it because they care about you.
Amen?
Because they didn't care, they wouldn't say anything. Amen? And God had given this lady here to be able to look me over us. Amen? To teach us. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Come out with a message that one day. Amen. And we should never do it without God's blessing.
All right.
God should be blessing everything that God bless everything that we do. Amen.
Yeah.
That's moving too soon. Hallelujah. In fact, sometimes we want to do what God doesn't have for us to do at all. It may not even be in God's will for our life. And then sometimes, although He has it for us, He doesn't have that for us right now. Because He knows us better than we know ourselves. And for that reason, He knows where our spiritual level is, where it needs to be. When God tells us to do something, He hold back in which our spirit is able to help, to handle whatever He told us to do. He might call you to be a pastor, but He ain't going to be a pastor right now. Something ain't running too fast.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. And we're not ready to do that.
That's right.
God haven't prepared us yet.
Yeah.
He called David to be king before David even became king.
Come on.
Amen. Yeah. David, he had to prepare him to be king.
That's right.
Amen. You got to be prepared. But he got to deal with us.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. He knows that we have maturity in Christ. We're not ready to land out right now. Therefore, by making true to that, the Lord has this for you. It may not be right now. Because they refuse to listen, they land out too soon. And shortly after landing, they fell into the midst of a raging storm. Look here. Sometimes we don't listen, we fall into a raging storm. Storm coming out alive, hallelujah, that we can't handle. And we wonder, where this storm coming from? Sometimes because we move too fast. Sometimes we seek God's blessing. Amen. Sometimes we heed to the word of God, man, to the man of God. Amen. That's what happens sometimes. Amen. The storm is identified in verse 14 in King James as a great storm. An awful storm. Yeah. The storm that the granddad of all storms. Wow. It was a wind of great fury that came out of the northeast. And Paul knew that the captain knew about these storms because the captain had went this course a lot of times. Yeah. Amen. But this particular storm that came, and I think this storm was out of order because they wouldn't listen to the man of God. He told them not to go. Amen. They would not listen. We don't listen, we run into a terrible storm, y'all. Yes. Amen. It came howling like out of the woods. It sounded like an ear, frightening. And it was a terrible thing. Amen. The storm was terrible, y'all. Amen. Amen. It was aggressive in the sea. It would cause the sea to become rough and troubled. Yeah. Amen. You ever seen, I know we're on a ship, but I see, I know Alfredo was here. I seen this ship with the storm come, the waves go up, and like turn the ship over to come back down like it's falling down.
Yeah.
Now I've been scared to death.
Yeah.
Amen. And the ship that was caught in the typhoon like situation finds himself being kicked like a football from one wave to the other. And a giant wave that was higher than the ship would beat against the ship wall. Water was splashing upon the ship. There was a small ship, y'all, on the board. And the men on board the ship would roll about and toss and throw like the marbles on the concrete floor. And they were in this life-threatening situation all because they didn't listen. And they lanced out too soon. But to make matters worse, the storm lasted a long time. Sometimes when a storm that lasts a long time. Amen? Because the storm lasts so long sometimes because we don't want to do what it takes to get out of the storm. Amen? We don't want to do what it takes to get out of the storm sometimes. Amen? God tells us to do something. We say, oh, I can't get rid of that. That's part of me. I can't drive that. I like doing that. I can't do that. Because, and that's why we stay in the storm the longer than we have to. And you know what? What we do? We blame God for being in the storm.
Yeah.
We put ourselves in the storm.
Uh-huh.
And the thing about it is, God can speak to us and say, if you do this right here, I can bring you out of the storm. Amen. But look here, we don't want to get rid of those things. Amen. We want to hold on to them.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. And it's something about life rather than the storm getting better, in spite of all our prayer, in spite of all that we've done, the storm is still raging inward. Somebody tell you in the life storm now, the storm of life can come in so many ways. Storm can come in your home and cause turmoil for you and your whole family. Look, storm just when you come in your life, they're coming in your family life. Amen. Hallelujah. Storms can get in the church and cause the entire congregation to fall apart. Why? Because we're not praying for them. Amen. When I pray for the whole family of Word of Faith Church. Not just the first lady. Amen. We gotta lift everybody up. Amen. Because the enemy is attacking all of us. And if you don't get look, just like Aiden. When one person sitting in the camp, they kill everybody in his camp.
Yeah.
Look, when one person is hurt, one person is going astray, it hurt the whole church.
Yes,
amen. Yes. Hallelujah. When someone is missing that you haven't seen in a long time, we need to pray for them.
Yeah.
Sometimes they don't call, but we need to pray for them. Lift them up. Ask God to bring them back.
That's right.
Amen. We don't know what storm they're in. Mm-hmm. It's something that drove them away. It don't have to be something that's happening in the church. God thank you to the church. If not, it could be something happening at home.
Yeah.
It could be something happening in their life. Amen. It could be they picked up an old habit and they said they weren't going to pick up no more.
Wow.
Hallelujah. I see the enemy keep bringing that thing back and forth you. Whatever you think is lacking in the world, whatever the enemy is going to attack you with.
Yeah.
If you're a woman now, you're attacking with pretty women. If you lose a drug, you got somebody coming to offer you some drugs.
Right.
Hallelujah. See, we got to be careful, hallelujah, that we stay prayed up.
Yeah.
We keep those things behind us.
Yeah.
Don't let them get in front of us, hallelujah. Some storms affect our health. One bad report from the doctor can cause our life to end up in a storm.
Yes.
Amen. One report from the doctor. I don't know about you, Dr. J. I can't. You're going to think about it.
Yeah.
Amen. But you got to know who you serve.
Yes.
Amen. You serve the Almighty God
yes.
that can do anything.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
These are those on board the ship of Paul were in an awful storm, and they kept on raging. And the storm. They kept on raising, and reported that on the third day, they started to throw heavy cargo overboard. Sometimes you got to throw some things overboard, y'all. Keep waiting and holding us down. To keep us in the storm, hallelujah. We got to get rid of some things. And there are some things, hallelujah, that we need to get rid of. Hallelujah. If you weigh us down, then they won't let you float like you ought to float. Hallelujah. They won't let you come to church like you ought to. They won't let you pray like you ought to. They won't let you fast like you ought to. In spite of the thunder, and in spite of the lightning, and in spite of the wave, that Stephen could destroy the ship, the angels told me everything would be all right. Because God's will is for me to take it to make it wrong. God got work for me to do it wrong, Paul said. And not only did he tell me I was going to make it there, but not one life on board of this ship will be lost.
Yes.
Now the ship is going to be torn up, but no one life will be lost.
Yes.
I have to tell you this morning, the storm is raging, but God has told me to tell you everything going to be all right.
Yes.
Amen. That song says, everything will be all right. Amen. If you, when you come out of the storm, everything will be all right.
Yes.
I want to tell you, it'll be all right for a minute. For a minute,
wow.
But another raging storm gonna come. Hallelujah. So you prepare yourself for it. But don't be afraid. God said, I'll always be by you.
Amen.
Always be by your side. Because we carry God inside of us. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The conclusion is that all I have to tell you is if you find yourself in a storm because you fail to listen and you last out too soon, the storm is lasting too long, don't give up in the storm, but hold on and keep the faith.
With holding nothing, with holding.